Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In today's class, we will discuss about how to construct a vernier scale. Okay, here vernier scale is using for marking three consecutive units like meters, decimeters and centimeters. We are marking by using the vernier scale accurately. We are using one more scale for marking three units. It is called diagonal scale. Here, let us take the vernier scale. In it, take the given question initially. A real length of 10 meters is represented by a line of 5 centimeters. So here we have to assume 10 meters is equal to 5 centimeter. Okay, we can't mark 10 meters on the sheet. So instead of 10 meters, we have to take 5 centimeter. Okay, on a drawing, full stop. Find the RF. RF means representative fraction. And construct a vernier scale such that at least count is 2 decimeter. And can measure up to 25 meters. We have to construct this vernier scale. It can measure up to 25 meters, maximum limit. Okay, full stop. Mark a distance of 19.4 meters on it. On the 25 meters vernier scale, we had to mark 19.4 meters. Okay, for constructing this vernier scale, we had to first write down the formula RF we need to find. RF is nothing but representative fraction. It is a ratio of drawing length to the original length. Drawing length means which is able to draw on the sheet. Virginal length means the given value. Okay, it may not be drawn on the sheet. It is not possible to draw on the sheet. 10 meters we can't do on the sheet. They have given 10 meters is represented by a line of 5 centimeter. The meaning is 10 meters of this virginal length, it is equal to 5 centimeter in the drawing. Okay, so substitute the values here. Drawing length is 5 centimeter we can able to draw. So it is 5 centimeter. Just mark the units also divided by virginal length. So 10 meters we can't do on the sheet. So it is 10 meters. So for cancelling both terms, we need to convert either in centimeters or meters. Both units should be same. Okay, I am keeping 5 centimeter as it is. So here 10 meters means 10 I am taking as it is. 1 meter means 100 centimeters. Okay, keep 100 here. Centimeters. So 5, 2 ja 10. Okay, it is nothing but 1 by 2 into 100, 200. Okay, centimeter, centimeter will be cancelled. 1 by 200 is the RF value. So here we have to find the RF. And then construct a vernier scale. We need to construct the vernier scale. For doing the vernier scale, we have to find the drawing length, how much length we have to take. They have given maximum limit that scale can measure up to 25 meters. We have to construct one scale which can measure up to 25 meters. It is the maximum limit. Okay. So take the same formula, okay, this formula. Find out the drawing length. We don't know about the drawing length, but we know the maximum limit of that scale, 25 meters. Okay. So take down the same thing here. Drawing length we have to find. The original length. 25 meters. It is a maximum limit. Okay, here write down 25 meters. It is nothing but 1 by 200 RF is. Now from this we have to find drawing length. Okay, so here drawing length is in centimeter. We are doing on the sheet. So convert this meter into centimeters. Okay, so write down here drawing length is equal to 25 will come here. 25 meters by 200. Convert this into centimeters. 25. 1 meter means 100 centimeter divided by 200 here. So this two zeros are cancelled. So 12.5 centimeters. This value is 12.5 centimeter. So drawing length is 12.5 centimeter. So this length we can mark by using this scale. Okay. Mark the initial point. So here 12.5. You just make one line. Okay. And here keep 1 centimeter. Make one box. So this side 1 centimeter and this side 1 centimeter. So do here parallel line. Join these two ends. Here I did the scale. It is 12.5 centimeter. But actually it represents 25 meters maximum limit. So with this scale we can measure up to 25 meters. 25 meters, let us divide into 5 parts. Okay, if you are dividing into 5 parts, each part is divided by 5. Means each part is 5 meters. Correct? So this 25 meters we are dividing into 5 parts. We can divide any number of parts here. So according to our convenient, so let us divide into 5 parts. 5 parts means each part is 5 meters. So here 5 meters, 5 meters, 5 meters like that, 5 parts. So total length we will get 25 meters. So here actual length we are taking drawing length is 12.5 centimeter. To divide this length 12.5 centimeter into 5 equal divisions. In engineering drawing we have one procedure for dividing any length into some equal number of parts. Here we have to do the inclined line. just do one line of some angle. This angle should be less than 90 degrees, okay? So after getting this line, by using compass, take any length, okay? Some radius. So from the starting point as center, just do an arc here. Okay, take this intersection point is the center, take the same radius, do an arc. So take, now take this point as center, do an arc here. Now take this point as center, do an arc. Like that, we have to divide into 5 parts. Okay, let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, join this last point to this last point of the scale. So just do one line. All the points, do the lines, okay, parallel to this line. For getting the parallel line, I am using roller scale. You can use drafter scale, it is easy to do the parallel lines. So fix a drafter scale here, move the scale at all the points. So these intersection points, at these points, do the vertical lines. Okay, these are the 5 equal divisions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this is the method. We can divide any line into required number of equal divisions. So total is 25 meters. We have divided into 5 parts. Each part is 5 meters. Okay, this is 5 meters, this is 5, like that. Okay, again divide this 5 meters into 5 equal divisions. Okay, each division is 1 meter. Same process we have to follow. We have to do one more line here. Or we can take the same line, we can take the small radius by using compass. We can divide this line, but it will get confusion. I'm taking one more line, inclined line, for dividing this into 5 equal divisions. Here do one more line. Okay, on it, divide this line into 5 equal divisions by using compass. Here we are dividing this length. Okay, so take the small radius for dividing the small length. Any radius. Initial point as center. So first one, second, third, fourth, fifth. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Join this last point to this point. Okay. So do the thin lines, light color with 2H pencil. So it should not visible, it should not dominate the main diagram. Okay. So just do the lines, parallel lines at all the points. By using drafter, it is easy to do the parallel lines. At these intersection points, do the vertical lines. Here we have divided this box into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 meters box into 5 equal divisions. Each represent 1 meter. After dividing this first box, divide the remaining boxes also 5 divisions. Now take this length by using compass. Okay, this length, first division length. And divide this box into 5 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is 5. Okay, 5 equal divisions. Here also we have to do the lines. So divide this box into 5 divisions. At all these points, do the vertical lines. So these are the divisions, equal divisions. Each box will represent 1 meter. Okay. And for marking these boxes, initially use 0. And this is one first box, and this is a second box, and this is a third box, and this is a fourth box, this is a fifth box. Okay, now this is 5 meters. So again we have divided into 5 equal divisions. Each box will give 1 meter. Okay, so this is the main scale. In vernier scale we have to construct one more scale here, this side. Okay, for constructing the vernier scale here, just extend this scale up to some length. Okay, whatever one box will be there, take the same box this side also. Okay, extend this side also. Here also extend. So on it, mark whatever length is there, this side first box, mark the same length this side also. Okay, first box. So mark here also, this side. and mark this side also. Okay. Now join these two points. Divide this 5 meters into 5 equal divisions. So take this division length by using compass. So mark those divisions in the first box also. 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 5. Okay. So at these points also do the vertical lines. For these divisions, give the names. Here with the 0 we are starting. Give 1 here, 2 here, 3 here, 4 here, 5. So here we will do the vernier scale. Here listen carefully. Just extend this line up to some length. Okay, up to some length. So on this side we have to mark the length of the vernier scale. For marking the length of the vernier scale, take the first box. How many parts we have divided here? 5 parts. Okay. Listen carefully here. We have divided the first box or any box into 5 parts. So on it mark 6 parts length on the vernier scale. For all the vernier scales we have to do like that. Let us assume we are dividing into 6 parts. So here you have to mark 7 parts length. Okay. So in our example we have divided into 5 parts, but we have to mark on the vernier scale 6 parts length. Okay, how to measure 6 parts length? So from 0 to 1, 5 parts. So this is a 6th part. Whatever this length is there, up to this. Okay, it is a 6 parts, 5 plus 1. So mark this length, 6 parts length on the vernier scale, this side. Okay, and then remove the extended line here. So here also take 1 centimeter length. Here also we took 1 centimeter. So here take 1 centimeter. Height of the vernier scale. Okay, now make one box from 0 to extend the line here also 1 centimeter. Now join these two points. So whatever 6 parts length is there from 0 to here we have marked on this side. Okay, divide this into same number of parts, whatever parts here we are dividing, divide this length into 5 parts. Okay, so how to divide this length into 5 equal divisions? Here also do one inclined line. Here we can do the inclined line, but this will cross the main diagram. That's why do the line here. Divide this length into 5 divisions. So for dividing into, I am taking one inclined line here. So on this line, I will divide this. So on this inclined line, by using compass, I will take 5 equal divisions. So this is the first division. This is the second division. This is the third one. This is the fourth, this is the fifth one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 equal divisions we did. Join this last point to this point. One. So at all the points, do the parallel lines. So at these points, intersection points, do the vertical lines. Take this as a reference line. So this is the vernier scale. We have divided this vernier scale into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. Okay, how much each part is? For calculating it, as we know, we took here 6 parts length here, correct? 6 parts means nothing but here this is 5 meters, this is 1 meter. Okay, 6 meters length this is. Okay, so for 6 meters length, we have divided into 5 parts. Each part is how much? Okay, so for 5 meters it is more, for 1 part it is less. Less by more into 6. So we will get here less means 1, more means it is 5 into 6. Okay, each part is 1.2 meters. Okay, but here we are marking this vernier scale for marking the small unit, not meters. Okay, so I will take this vernier scale for marking decimeters. Okay, now here convert this 1.2 meters into decimeters. As we know, 1 meter means 10 decimeters. Okay, 1.2 meters means how many decimeters? 1.2 into 1 meter means 10 decimeters. Okay, so it is nothing but 12 decimeters. So each part is 1.2 meter means 12 decimeters. So this is 12. So start from here, 0 we have marked here. This is 12 decimeters. So next division is also 12. Okay, 12 plus 12 means 24 decimeters. Next 24 plus 12 means it is 36 decimeters. So 36 plus 12 means here 48 decimeters. 48 plus 12 means it is 60. Okay, 0, 12, plus 12 means 24, plus 12 means 36, plus 12 means 48, plus 12 means 60. Like that we are marking. Each division is indicating 12 decimeters. This is a vernier scale. In this scale, we have to mark a distance of 19.4 meters. Just now I have done here, 19.4 meters we need to mark. Marking this 19.4 meters, here on the vernier scale, where the 4 is coming. Here if you are taking 12, here 24, at the end, whatever this number is coming, so take the same number at the end. So 4 is coming at the 24. Okay, 2, 4 is there. So take this 2, 4. So here we are taking meters. 24 decimeters means 2.4 meters. Correct? So take 2.4 meters. Okay. So remove 2.4 meters from it. So here we have to mark 19.4 meters. So 0.4 is coming. You check on the vernier scale where 4 is coming at the end. So 24 is coming here. So take 24 here, 24 decimeters, okay? So 2.4 meters, remove this 2.4 meters in the given value. So here 0, here it is coming, 9 minus 2 means 7, 17 meters. We need to mark this value on this scale, okay? So here at 24, here we took 24, correct? So at 24, do the vertical line, starting line. Just do the line here, extend the line. After getting this line, mark the 17 meters on the main scale. Okay, 17 meters means, as we know, from 0 it is 5 meters, 10 meters, 15 meters, 15, 16, 17. As we know, each box is 5 meters. 5 meters, 10 meters, 15 meters, for 15, 17 we need to mark, 15, this is 1 meter, 16 meter, this is 17 meter. At 17, do the vertical line. Okay, this gap will give the 19.4 meters. I have to mark on the scale. Just take the parallel line here. Take this is the reference line. Do the dimensional line here. On it, mark 19.4 meters at the middle of the dimensional line. Keep the arrows. Okay, in this method, we have to mark. If you are taking this value, total value 19.4. This value is 2.4 and the remaining value is 17 meters. Okay, 2.4 plus 17. Total is 19.4 meters. If we are adding these two, this plus this value, we will get this value, 19.4 meters. In this scale, write down this scale is measuring meters. It is called main scale. We can give the names for it, for the main scale, A, B, C and D. Okay, A, B, C, D is a main scale. Here scale mark the corners E, F, G, H. Okay, it is a vernier scale. And this scale is measuring meters and this scale is measuring decimeters. Here, this length, okay, from this 0 to this length, 5 length is nothing but drawing length. How much it is? 12.5 cm. Mark that length. And write down RF value. We have calculated RF is equal to how much? 1 by 200. So here I have marked 1 is to 200. In this way, we can mark the dimension. Let us take one more example. It has not given in the question. Just I will mark this value, 12.6 meters, okay, in this scale. So take the last number, 6 is there. In the vernier scale, take where the 6 number is coming at the end. 36 is coming here, okay, take that 36. So 36 decimeters, okay, so 3.6 meters. So remove 3.6 meters from the given number, okay. 6 minus 6 means 0, point. 12 minus 3 means 9. Okay, so 9 meters here we have to mark. Okay, for marking this 9 meters, first take 3.6. At 3.6 we took the line. Here we have to take one line. Just do one line here. Okay, 3.6. I took one line here. After that, after marking this, we have to mark and mark 9 meters in the main scale. 9 meters means this is 5 meters, 6 meters, 7 meters. 8 meters, 9 meters. Okay, here also do one line. Extend the line. Now take from 3.6 to this one. Just mark that length. It is nothing but
12.6 meters. Okay, mark the arrows at both sides. So if you are observing here, this is 3.6 meters. Okay, this gap, and the remaining gap is 9 meters. Okay, if you are adding these two values, this plus this value, we will get the 12.6 meters. Okay, add these two values, we will get this value plus this value. So in this way, we can mark the given dimension in the vernier scale. If you like this lecture, hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Share with your friends. Other video lectures of scales, I give the link in description box. Please check it. Thank you for watching.